What's up, guys? Don't forget to check out the Nuclear Reactions merch store. Grab yourself a shirt or some other item to show your love and support for the channel. Check out the link in the description below the video. I'm Blake X, and this is another Nuclear Reaction. What's up, survivors? So it's been a while since I've done a rap reaction on this channel. Now, you guys should know by now that every once in a while, I try and do it a little bit more often these days, I try and branch out to genres outside of just metal. So I'll do stuff like punk reactions, rap reactions, retro wave, I've done witch house, some country music. I try and do a little bit of everything, try and explore other music genres and see what I like, because there's so much stuff out there in the music world, you know, even beyond the metal scene, that I just don't know and I'm not familiar with. So it provides a very good opportunity for me to hear new artists, new types of music, stuff that's outside my wheelhouse and outside my comfort zone. And this is going to be another example of that. Because if you don't know or if you don't remember, I've never really liked rap. But in the short time that I've been doing some of these non-metal reactions on this channel, I have enjoyed slightly, or at least respected artistically, some of the rap songs that I have heard. Like the one that Public Enemy did with Anthrax. Like the Denzel Curry one that I did, which was a Rage Against the Machine cover. So there have been a couple of things. And I know those were not pure rap songs, but, you know. Anyway, my point is, there are a couple of rap-oriented songs that I've been able to understand and respect and appreciate in some way, even if it's not necessarily my thing. Now, I did one Scarlxrd reaction before, and so this is going to be my second Scarlxrd reaction, and today I'm checking out No Pressure. Now, this song was requested. It's an item from the Infinite List, and this was asked for by Sturban Kira and DDDSSS. I don't know, maybe that's supposed to be didn't. I have no clue. But those are the two people that I'm aware of who have requested this song, and it was a while ago, so this was sitting on the list for, you know, a bit. It's part of the backlog on the list that I'm digging into. So, you know, it's about time that I do some more requests, because I've done several reactions that I picked, to songs that I picked, over the past few days. So I'm getting back to the list and giving you guys what you want. And if I'm remembering correctly, the first Scarlxrd song that I heard, I found it to be interesting, but it didn't quite cut it for me musically. I don't think I've gone back and listened to it since the reaction, but that was only one song. And a couple people in the comments told me that it was not the best example of Scarlxrd. So today I'm going to check out No Pressure, including the official music video, so I really hope it doesn't get blocked. I'll be pissed if it does. And that's what we're going to do. The Patreon page will be coming very, very soon. I'm hoping to get it up this very weekend. In fact, by the time you're watching this reaction, it might already be up if things go according to plan. And so in the very next video that I do, if that's the case, I'll let you guys know what the link is. I'll give all the relevant info regarding the Patreon page. And also, you can find relevant information and important information in the official Facebook group for Nuclear Reactions, which is the Mushroom Cloud. Link to that will be in the description beneath the video. Also in the description beneath the video will be a link to the official merch store, Ye Olde Nuclear Shop. So if you want to buy a shirt or some other item to show your support for the channel and be a part of the Nuclear family, that is an excellent way to do it. All right. My usual ramblings are over, so let's just get into this. Don't forget to give this a thumbs up if you like it. Hit the subscribe button. All it takes is one click. And let's check out No Pressure in 3, 2, 1, go. You speak in Russian?
Давай сюда! Садись сюда! Дай нам все, что надо! Мы тебя прикончим здесь!
Appropriate response.
Скажи нам имя!
I'm a ghost of peace, don't blame me, I can't fuck face, I'm a slave, 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 I'm a Very interesting rapping style that he's got. Like, I'm not familiar with rap by any means, beyond what I've reacted to on this channel. But it seems like he's combining, like, an almost, like, I don't want to call it screamo because that sounds insulting, and I'm not trying to be insulting here, but it sounds like that type of, like, kind of scream singing combined with, like, a rapping style and a rapping cadence. It's really interesting stuff, man. Even if it's not quite my thing, as I'm sure you guys know, this is an interesting video so far. Strange, but engaging. And I think this video might have a deeper meaning that connects with the lyrics. And I do have the lyrics pulled up, and I'm going to get to them after the video. But very interesting so far. Let's keep it going. Good voice. All right, that was interesting. I got to take a minute to process that one. He was pretty good at pulling up some raw emotion with his voice, especially when he really got into like the more intense kind of scream rapping that he was doing. Seems like a talented dude in terms of vocals. Those parts I could kind of get into very slightly. The traditional rapping parts that I heard were kind of like, I don't know, man. It just, maybe eventually my mind will change on it, my feelings will change on it, but it just doesn't do it for me, man. You know, I don't know. I don't know what it is about rapping. Something about it just does not grab me or pull me in, you know. But, you know, maybe it depends on the artist and the song. Maybe that'll change. Also, like, the type of beat that they have in rap songs, typically, like, for example, the beat that they had in this song, like, it's just something about the beat just, like, kind of stresses me out almost, rather than me enjoying it. Like, it just, like, kind of feels agitating to me. I'm, like, not in a good way. But that's just my opinion. You know, yours may differ. The video is very interesting. I think it really did a good job of driving home the point. And I'm going to get to the point, but first, I just want to go over the lyrics here and see what they had to say. Believe they came to save you, but they can't sleep enough. Hold up, whip, and head down. I'm leaving. Plan the running. Took me to their death. I'm done with smiling in meetings, because shits don't want to have fun. All the guards are pissed off, believing that I keep front face if I sleep at night. I don't believe you guys anymore. I don't believe in lies no more. I don't care about conscience. I'm psycho. I'm taming to go where I want. Scarlxrd, shake his mask or what? Fuck up your set. Gonna get fucked. I send 10 sets to your family. Broke your tour yard and get tough. No, you won't. Hoping he gets to fuck you up. I'm one of the stars that you piss me off. Living inside. Is it serious? I look in the mirror. Who is this? Inside the beyond yourself. I focus on pulling my business. Don't give no fucks about you. I don't want to play this game no more. I don't want to make the same mistakes no more. It's like they're pushing me to get out of my brain. I don't want to play this game no more. I'm living the life that I love. Leave me alone. Make sure you find me some clout. I got money. Yeah, I mean, They're going to take a chance to die to the real end, making a rack and it's serving. I don't feel no pressure. Yeah, you know, this feels like it's very much... I feel like this song describes someone dealing with a life full of... Obviously, a life full of pressure. But despite that, the person does not feel the pressure at all. Like, or he's got such a handle on it that it doesn't even affect him anymore. Like, the shit just goes over him, you know? And I think the video with him getting beaten by these people and, you know, grinning and taking it like a champ, I think pretty much drives home that point very strongly. And, you know, I feel like that really is a thing. Like, some people eventually break under pressure. They just snap. They can't take it anymore. And other people, I feel like sometimes the pressure and the stress and the bullshit and the chaos become so insurmountable that instead of breaking, you kind of like loop back around and stop being affected by it. As crazy as that sounds, I really think that's like a legitimate emotional response that some people have. It's just like, you know what? I'm so fucking over this now. I just don't give a shit anymore. I'm just going to be happy and I'm just going to do me. It's like that kind of attitude, you know? And I think that a lot of us have felt that way at a certain point. Like, we just kind of turn around and we look at the situation and we say, why is this affecting me like this? You know, fuck it. And this seems to be a situation, maybe even something from the artist's personal life, in which there are people that are deliberately trying to make life harder for him, which I feel, you know, is alluded to in lines like, I'm one of the stars that you piss me off. You know, in other words, there are plenty of people like me who just take your shit and swallow it, who just deal with it, you know, yes men and what have you, and they just go along with what they're supposed to do. But he's one of the ones that gets pissed off by it, and he's not going to go along with it, and he's not going to tolerate it. And there are tons of people like this in life that try and, you know, cause all these problems for people. You know, and it happens in normal settings, you know, like people like you and me, and it also happens for established artists and musicians. And 9 times out of 10, they're, you know, just insolent and resentful of your success, and they want to bring you down in some way. And I myself have dealt with people like this, you know, on a smaller scale, but nevertheless, like people who are just really bitter and jealous, and it's obvious, and it shows through their behavior, you know? And, you know, I say this all the time, and this may sound like an asshole statement, but in my eyes, it's very true. I always say jealousy is a disease. Get well soon, you know? It really is. And, you know, that should be your attitude, because it's like if you crack under the pressure or let these people's actions actually negatively impact your life, you've already placed yourself in a position of weakness, whether intentionally or otherwise, you know. So it's an interesting situation psychologically, because most people feel a desperate inclination to respond or retaliate in some way when someone makes some kind of asinine remark or insulting or defamatory comment about you, you know, or engages in some kind of passive aggressive or otherwise manipulative or abusive behavior. And but that automatically positions you into a direct line of engagement with the person who supposedly you can't stand and who is supposedly beneath you. But by engaging with them, you're telling them that what they actually say or think about you, you know, really affects or bothers you in some way. And so you're actually dignifying their behavior. And you really have to be above and beyond it. That's the way that, you know, that's the best way to deal with those kinds of people. And look, my advice on that is most of the people who want to, you know, fuck with you and mess with you and mess up your life, they're already suffering from unwarranted self-importance, you know? It's like, so don't contribute further to it by playing their little games, you know? When it comes to people who desperately waste their time trying to get your attention and ironically enough, while they simultaneously hate or resent you, go figure. You know, I've learned that, you know, in my mere 30 years of existence, I've learned that smiling and laughing and then walking away is the absolute best response, hands down. Closely followed by just traditional planned ignoring, you know. And these these two methods are worse for them than if you had spit in their face, I'm telling you. Because it tells them that they're not worth your time or even a modicum of your attention. Narcissistic people in particular really go batshit crazy when you show them that kind of response. And, you know, look, I mean it too. Like, let that smile and let that laugh be genuine. You know, don't be petty and don't sink to their level. Stay happy, man, you know, and stay positive. You have no reason not to. They're the negative ones. So don't let them be psychic vampires and, you know, drain your emotions from you. I mean, you know, and it's a pretty simple and straightforward response to just, you know, smile, shrug your shoulders, and walk it off, you know? You know, some random person that you'll never see again made some asshole remark about you or, you know, tried to screw you over in some way. Big deal, you know? Who the hell are they? But, you know, it's not surprising because I've seen this so many times, but, you know, it's just interesting to me how much people feel the need to immediately have like a knee-jerk reaction to people like that instead of just walking away. You know, now I think the context of this song is that of the music industry and everything that comes along with it. Because, you know, he talks about guards and sitting at board meetings and all that kind of, you know, the business side of the music industry and all that kind of bullshit. Which is interesting because I just reacted to the Kasakhtha song, the Pink Floyd cover, and that dealt with the music industry and all the stresses and feelings of entrapment that come along with that. But this song seems to be taking the exact opposite approach, and Scarlxrd is basically saying, you know, hey, fuck it, I'm over it. I've got a handle on myself and who I am, and, you know, the line here says, I focus on pulling my business, don't give no fucks about you. So it's basically saying, to hell with you people and your system. I'm an artist, and I know who I am, and I'm going to do things exactly the way that I want. And, you know, look, that's a little something that we call integrity. You know, yeah, man, you know, I can get behind that statement for sure. So he's basically reached the point in his life where he doesn't have to prove anything to anyone. You know, he feels complete self-awareness and self-confidence. And I think that is a position that everyone should aspire to get to. It's good for you emotionally and mentally. It's just good all around, you know, and that's a core part of my belief system, as I've said many times. And I've pretty much been in that spot for years now, you know. I've gotten to the point where I actually see how fucking ludicrous it is to take people's hate or their negative drama to heart. Especially people who are not big parts of your life, people who are not important to you. It's pretty logical to me. I mean, just, there's no reason that should cause you any grief, you know. As for the pressure part, that's, I'll admit, that's one thing that I still haven't mastered, getting past, you know, the stress and anxiety in my daily life sometimes still seems kind of challenging to me, you know, it's still something I struggle with. And I think that's actually much harder for most people to do, to, you know, not crack under the pressure, to just stay cool, to just stay calm, and just keep doing you. But some people are like that, though. Some people can remain that way, and actually, me being like a sponge, you know, I'm kind of an empath, so I really pick up on the emotions or the energies of the people around me. So, like, when I'm hanging out with someone who is extremely calm under pressure, that sort of transfers to me in a weird way. Like, you know, when things go wrong and I don't have control over the situation, sometimes I get pretty stressed out about it. Like, I remember a couple years ago, it was actually 4 or 5 years ago now, and I was with two colleagues of mine, two of my coworkers at the time, and we were going to this metal show. And, so one of them, a buddy of mine, Urschel, what's up, Urschel, if you're watching this, you know, so basically we got out of the venue after the show ended, right, and it was really late at night, and so we were going to try and catch a bus back to downtown, and then from there another bus back to, you know, where we all lived or whatever, and the buses had stopped running, and this venue was kind of like in the middle of nowhere, you know, it was, everything was closed down, and you know, things closed down in Chicago pretty early. I don't even know why, but anyway. So it was late, and we were kind of stranded, you know. And I remember, like, Urschel was, like, really calm about it. Like, he was, like, so cool and so collected about it. He was like, well, we don't really have a lot of options. You know, like everything. Like, we're totally stranded, and we're stuck here, like, 3 a.m, but it's all good. but you know what? It kind of rubbed off on me, and I didn't get stressed for a change. And eventually it worked out. I think we walked to somewhere else, and it was like a bit of a walk, but we got a bus from there, and then from there we got home. But anyway, and it just goes to show why you shouldn't get so stressed and flip out so much over little situations like that, because those things usually tend to resolve themselves and work themselves out. And there's always a solution to every problem. You just got to keep calm, keep cool, keep your clarity of thought, figure out what you're going to do, and just do it. And that's usually what he seems to do in those situations. And, so at the time, that rubbed off on me, and I handled that pretty well also. What I have to learn, though, is how to take that calm feeling and that lack of giving a fuck and apply it to my everyday life, which is easier said than done, you know. And by saying not giving a fuck, I'm not saying don't care about shit, you know. I'm saying don't let things bring you down and cause you unnecessary stress. You know, life is short. You know, don't make it shorter. Again, look, as long as you're doing you and being yourself and you're at peace with that, people can't bring you down. They can't hurt you. And you can get a handle on any kind of situation. People only have control over you. And they can only create an environment of pressure and stress. And they can only crush your soul if you let them, you know. It all comes down to you, man, you know. In most situations, anyway. It definitely starts with having a good sense of self-awareness and having a good mental image of yourself. And I think that's a sentiment that's echoed here in this song, you know. I'm living the life that I love. Leave me alone. That should be everyone's attitude, man. So, a strong and on-point message with this song, for sure. As you guys probably predicted, it's not my thing musically. But because the lyrics were good, because the video was interesting, and because it seems like Scarlxrd is actually pretty talented with his vocals, he puts an interesting spin on rapping with the whole kind of like screaming cadence that he has, and he seems to put a lot of emotion into his stuff. I do respect it artistically because of all those different factors. So I'm going to give this one a 5 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. I feel like that's a solid rating, especially when it comes to the fact that I don't really like the music itself. But all those other elements make it a 5 for me. So there you have it. No Pressure by Scarlxrd, and scratch that item off the infinite list. Only a million more to go. So, as always. But I'm excited and happy to do it. And really appreciate the support, as always. Appreciate everyone who has subscribed. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And that is all I got for you guys today. So I will catch you on the next one.